There are tons of hidden features in Google Chrome that you almost never hear about. So I thought I would go over 11 pretty cool features that you don't really ever hear about in Google Chrome. Some of them are really useful, a couple of them are just pretty neat, but either way, you should be pretty interested, especially if you use Google Chrome as your primary browser. And of course, as usual, if you guys do enjoy this video at any point, please give it a thumbs up, I'd appreciate it, just so the YouTube algorithm knows that you actually liked it. So let's get started. Now, the first couple settings are actually in a hidden settings window that you probably didn't even know existed. There are a bunch of these in Chrome, but the first one that I want to mention is the Chrome Flags page. So to get to this, all you do is go into the Google address bar and type in Chrome:// flags, and that will bring up a bunch of hidden and experimental settings that you can't access from anywhere else. The first one I want to talk about within this page is the tab muting UI control feature, which basically makes it so anytime a browser tab is playing something, it'll show a speaker symbol. And in addition to that, you can actually mute that tab just by clicking on that speaker symbol. So you don't have to go searching for which tab is playing the audio. And if it is, then instead of having to go to the tab and finding the video, then you can just click on the speaker symbol and it will mute the entire tab. So there's no fussing around trying to figure out how to do it. Alternatively, you could also right click on that tab if it's playing music and click mute tab, but it does the same thing. Number two is the fast tab window close setting. And this, I don't really understand the explanation, but essentially it does something with JavaScript and loads the tab in a different way so that when you go to close it, it supposedly makes it close faster, or if it's a window, close the window. I don't know if I personally noticed a difference because maybe my computer is just closing it fast anyway, but I think it's good to at least enable. I mean, why not? And that way, if you do come across a tab, sometimes you try to exit something, it doesn't quite respond right away. Hopefully, in some situations, enabling this feature will make the tab close instantly, you would hope. Number three is being able to disable smooth scrolling. That's another setting in here. I personally hate smooth scrolling. It's terrible in my opinion. I like to be able to scroll and have it go right with the mouse. So there is a setting on the flags page that just is says smooth scrolling, and you can disable it that way. Don't have to worry about it anymore, because at some point Google Chrome did introduce smooth scrolling by default. No idea why they would do this. I think it's a terrible feature. It's not even a feature, it just makes everything annoying, so you can disable it. Number four is another one of these hidden settings pages, which is the net internals. So it's Chrome:// net-internals, and this is gonna show you all sorts of complex and interesting network data that you may or may not be able to ever use, but it's still neat to be able to see. So for example, there's a DNS section, so maybe if something is not resolving or it says DNS error, you can go to that page and see which servers it's using or something like that if you know how to do that. There's also a bandwidth page where it'll show you all the bandwidth in real time. It's like a timeline, so that's pretty cool. So if you have to maybe see what speed something's downloading at over time, that could be useful. There's also a bunch of other settings that I have no idea what they do, to be honest, and maybe no one even knows except if you're a developer, but you might still want to be able to play around with it and see what other kind of stuff's in there. And number five is also another settings page, the Quota Internals, so Quota-Internals, and this is going to show you the space usage on your hard drive. So whether it's the Chrome software as a whole or individual websites. So you can go and expand it and see what kind of storage each website might be using as a temporary cache. So maybe if you notice that Chrome is taking up a bunch of space for some reason and kind of get an idea of maybe why this website is loading slow, you can see that it's huge. It's a huge website and it's just taking long to download. So a lot of useful, possibly, information in there. All right, now number six is one that is pretty useful, and you guys may not have realized this before, but you can actually use Google Chrome to play basically any video or audio or media file. And to do that, all you do is drag the file into Chrome. Just drag it in as if it was a new tab, and then it will open up that file and let you play it. And why this would be really useful especially is when you combine it with the casting feature. So you may have realized that if you have a Google Cast, a Chromecast rather, or Google Cast feature in a TV or something, you can actually broadcast that tab or Google Chrome as a whole to the TV or the Chromecast. So you can, what you can do is load that video or audio into Chrome and it'll play it, and then you can broadcast that and cast that video now to your TV. So you don't actually have to use any special software. It's supported right in Chrome. So that's actually really useful, especially for those of you who have a Google Chromecast, but if not, you can still use it to play video files quickly. All right, next, number 7 is not useful at all. It's the T-Rex game. It's a fun little thing that's hidden in Chrome. And to get to this, it's actually on the network disconnected page. So you can either disconnect from the internet altogether or just go directly to that error page, even if you're connected. So the URL is right here. It's networkerror/106 or something like that. But if you go to that URL in Chrome, then it will bring up the network error page. And then what you do, you'll see the T-Rex, and you press the space bar, and now it will start a running game of the T-Rex. You just jump over stuff. It's like a fun little Easter egg, basically. Not useful at all, but kind of funny to show your friends. All right, now number 8 isn't exactly a feature that's built into Chrome per se, but it's still something having to do with Chrome that Google doesn't really advertise and I think is cool, and that is the Chrome Experiments website. This is a website that is run by Google and is basically used to host different examples of cool demos that developers have created using different Chrome features and technologies, kind of as a way to demo some awesome stuff they've made. So you just go to chromeexperiments.com and then you don't even have to install anything. You just mostly just click on it and it'll run whatever neat little applet someone has created. And none of these are really useful at all, but still it's another thing that is neat and maybe give you some ideas if you're a developer or if you want to just see all the cool stuff that people are coming up with. All right, number 9 is another very useful one. This is the Chrome Task Manager. So like Windows, Chrome actually has its own task manager. And to get to this, you go to the regular settings button, and then you go to more tools and expand that and go to task manager. And now it's going to show you all the different processes running within Chrome. So that includes the different tabs and also the plugins that you may have running, the extensions, and then it'll show you all the information about each of these processes running. So it'll show you the CPU usage of each, the RAM usage, how much network data, all that sort of stuff. So if a plugin is being slow or something like that, or maybe you notice Chrome is running really slowly lately after you install an extension, or maybe something is causing a bunch of issues and you're not sure which extension it could be, you just look at the extensions in the task manager and kind of go from there. All right, coming near the end, number 10 is the Find My Phone feature. This is very similar to Apple's Find My iPhone feature, although I do believe this is only for Android phones. So what you do is you just type in Find My Phone into the Google Chrome address bar, and it'll bring up a Google page, Google search page, with the dialog box and information about how to find it. It'll probably make you log in, but then it'll basically just show a map after locating your phone via GPS and show you exactly where it is or possibly where it last was. And then you have a couple options from there. You can actually ring the phone, so play a sound. It'll actually also play a message on there. So if someone stole it, you can say, hey, I'm gonna get you or something like that. And then there's also a recover phone option, which gives you several options, either from locking the phone or even erasing it. So you have a lot of options there just by typing in Find My Phone in case you lose it or just can't find it. All right, now finally, this is the best, most useful feature in all of Chrome. It's my favorite. Most of you hopefully already know about this, but I thought I would mention it just in case you didn't, and that is the reopen closed tabs feature. And you can do this by either right clicking in the top bar and clicking restore closed tab, or just pressing Control Shift T. Remember that command, Control Shift T. I use it all the time. If you close a tab accidentally, or maybe you've even closed several, and the one you wanted to look back at, you closed several times ago, you can just keep pressing it, and it'll open up your most recently closed tabs, and it'll open to the same page, because I don't believe it gets rid of the actual storage and information that was in those until you close Chrome as a whole. So super useful, super simple. I don't know if it's exactly a hidden feature, but it is one that I know a lot of people don't know about, and it is probably one of the most useful features, I think. So you guys need to know about it if you didn't already. And I think that's it. Those are 11 hidden features in Google Chrome. Some of them are very useful. Some of them are just kind of neat. So hopefully you found it pretty interesting, maybe didn't know about too many of them. And if you guys did like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps. Also, we can talk down in the comment section. Is there anything I completely missed? I'd love to hear from you guys about that. And don't forget to thumbs up other comments from other people that you think are neat. Also, I thought I'd plug my Instagram. I don't really talk about it that often, so if you guys don't follow me on there, I try to post pretty cool stuff only. Not gonna spam you, I don't post that often. So go check it out, I'd appreciate it. If you guys wanna continue watching, I've got some other videos I'll put right here. You can click on these even if you're on a phone, so that's neat. And also, if you want to subscribe, be sure to do that because I make new videos at least 3 times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also consider clicking that bell next to the subscribe button so you get notified in case YouTube doesn't want to show you my videos. You'll at least know that it's up. So overall, thank you guys again for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.